Okay, ITS 128, and today is February 12th, and we are in the last day of chapter. Can you somebody hold on? We're the last day of chapter 4, and just an announcement. Next Thursday, we're gonna have a couple of people coming in to give a short presentation, and you have to attend that class. So I'll send out an email, and I actually believe it'll be okay to do it online. But if you could come to class, that would be even better. So I'll send out an email regarding that, and the quiz on Thursday, quiz number 13, is going to be related to that. So today I'd like to show you checkboxes and the switch statement, and I'm gonna use our color matching program that we've already finished pretty close. We're pretty much done with that. Got one more day here, so I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna convert it to, so I'm gonna add some things, and I will add using checkboxes, and I'll actually use a switch statement also for that. And then I'll also add a list box, so you can see how that works. So let me share my screen. And it occurred to me, I was watching my videos, and it occurred to me that when I move my mouse around on the screen in PowerPoint, that you can't see me moving my mouse around on the screen. So I'm gonna start maybe by, see, we did that already. If then else, we should definitely know if then else by now. Decision structures, Boolean variables, we know. Comparing strings, comparisons, yeah, we know that. The conversions, we aren't really using this with this assignment, try parse. No, we're not. Input validation. We're going to get a lot more into input validation as we progress, especially when we have to start using text boxes and we're entering stuff into text boxes. You know, when we enter numbers into text boxes, we need to be able to validate that, and so. To do that, we'll use try parse input validation. We'll use try parse. We can do input validation by using exception handling, where if they type in the wrong thing, and let's say they type in some letters and you want to convert that to a number, you just try it, and if it doesn't work, the system catches the error, and then you can do things based on to do things at that time, and you can actually look and see what caused the error, what was input that caused the error, and deal with it that way. That's usually not the preferred way to do it, because you know we always like to have control over our programs. There's things you cannot do by doing input validation. With input validation, your program looks at the input, and you do this try parse thing, which actually tests to see before you try to convert the input into a number. What try parse does is look at the input and tells you whether or not it is convertible. If it's not convertible, then it returns false, And then based on false, you go do something saying, please enter in something that's convertible. And then if it is convertible, it actually does the conversion. But we'll get into that later. We've covered radio buttons because that's what we did for our assignment. But today I'm going to talk about checkboxes. I'm going to do the same assignment using checkboxes. And there's the text field and the text property and the checked property and all these things. Checkboxes also have a text property and a checked property. Of course, the difference between a checkbox and a radio button is that you can have more than one checkbox checked at once. With radio buttons, you can only have one thing checked at once. With checkboxes, you can also have no things checked. Radio buttons, there's always at least one thing checked, except for when you start up. And this checked change event, that's what we use. That's the event. So that's something happens on the screen, and then you go off and you execute the code in here. And this checked change event for this radio button is what defines the method which will execute when that event occurs. Switch statement is like sort of like an if then an if else if sort of if else if is more flexible. Switch switch can be easier to code. Switch, if you can use a switch statement, it's generally more efficient than if else if, although you know, we're talking about minor differences in efficiency. That's you should use, first of all, what's most comfortable, and second of all, you know, your preference. We can get by in life very easily without a switch statement. It's kind of a redundant construct in programming languages, although most of them have them. Ever since the 90s, we've had switch statements. Before then, we didn't so much. If else if is more versatile. I don't use switch statements for anything. I'd much rather use it. So this is the general format of a switch statement. This is spelled incorrectly. Should be switch, not stitch. So you have a test expression. You'll see how this works. And these are different values based on the values. This is a flowchart, like you're looking at a month. It's going to be an integer between 1 and 12 inclusive, and so this is case 1 January, case 2 February, case 3 March, and then you could have the rest of them if you wanted to, and then at the very bottom you can optionally have a default which will catch all the rest of them or not. If you have a switch statement and none of the cases are true, it just would skip out and not do anything. List boxes are they can be like checkboxes and they can be like radio buttons. At this stage in our programming skill set, it's kind of complicated to make list boxes like checkboxes. In other words, to be able to select more than one thing and then write code based on that, because we have to know the concept of a collection. And we aren't going to learn about collections until later on when we talk about arrays, after arrays. But I'll show you how to use that today. We'll use this selected item to string dealing with colors. Selected item. Selected index. selected index will be an index of 0 through something. This is how you'd use selected index. So let's get out of here and open up our, see where we are. Did I save any kind of program? What did I upload for myself? Assignments. What do I have here for assignments? Color mixer. I didn't attach anything. Did I put anything in my Dropbox? No, I didn't. All right, so it looks like I got to do something from scratch. Let's do it. Visual Studio 2017. By the way, I did grade your assignments. I graded assignment one, assignment two, and because I messed up in setting up, a couple weeks ago or whatever, I went in there and I was messing around with some stuff. And I accidentally made it so there was no place to before the due date, I made it so there was no place for you to answer, put your answers in for assignment one. So I actually, extended these due dates so to February 20. So that's a ways away. So February 21st. How do I do this? 21, 22, 23, 24. But just so you know, you know, if you do something, if you submit something, and you know, I'm not going to grade these until after the due date. Well, actually, I did. I graded one and two, but you still have, if you do something like you mess up or you submit the wrong thing or anything, and I'll usually ask you if you want to resubmit. And I can extend the due date for you. So the goal for me is to get you to write as much code, to write as many programs, to spend as much time in this class, doing this class's work as I possibly can. And so I'm not gonna have a silly thing like a deadline that passes, give you an excuse not to do the assignment. Okay, well, I can't do the assignment. It's past the deadline. Okay, we'll just extend the deadline for you, and you do the assignment. So it's very important. If you're out in the real world, you can always get an extension, unless you're on the Navy SEAL team and you're going to go capture Osama bin Laden or some crazy thing like that. But we're not going to do anything like that. So. If you're a special kind of person to do that. So, you know, we're trying to help educate the more general population here. So let's do this color mixer thing. So let me start a new project, and this time I'm gonna do use checkboxes. This, and let me put this someplace where I can get at it again. I will put this down in my this PC, thaw space Halverson. I'll just put it here. No, I don't want to select that folder. Color mixer. It's there already. So let me go grab that. I'm going to grab that. Why did I put that in chapter 3? Who knows? So I'm just going to start this up instead. let's see what I did here. Oh, cute. There's nothing here. I forget it. I'm going to just do this one. New project. Did it delete out or something? Browse. This PC. Allspace. Halverson. That's my folder. And it's going to be, I'm going to call it, it's going to Windows Form Application. And I'm going to call it Color Mixer 2. All right. Now, for this one, let's look at some other little goodie that I passed down to you guys here. Click on Resources. Ooh, got to get rid of this. Go to Resources, and this, did I not make it visible? I don't see it here. Maybe it's an image. Color wheel, this thing. Here we go. Look at this. Okay. So look at this nice color wheel here. I'm going to get it out of here. Okay, if you look at this color wheel, notice that let's look at this for a moment. Let me just make some more room here. Where's my color wheel? So we have, we're using these binary numbers. We know about binary numbers now because y'all did assignment one. And these are the colors that we're talking about, and these are for mixing colors, and you call red. Red and blue make purple. Red and yellow make orange. Red and blue and yellow make green. And in fact, if you mix all three of them together, you get black. And if you take them all away, you get white. Okay, so if you think of this, the highest order bit, as they say, can I make a pen? Let me make a nice color that's not here yet. Okay. The highest order bit, is red. The second highest order bit is yellow. And the lowest order bit is blue. If we add red and blue together, we get, this is the highest order plus the lowest order, we get purple. If we add the second, green is these two, which is these two. And if you recall converting binary numbers into decimal numbers, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7. And it works out because, blue plus yellow is 0, 0, 1 plus 0, 1, 0. 1 plus 2 is 3, and that's what that is, 0, 1, 1. So basically we're adding two numbers in binary. For this one, we're adding three numbers in binary. Okay, so I'm just gonna set that aside here, and I wanna get rid of that stuff so nice and plain. So I'm gonna use this. So I'm gonna put check boxes up here, and I'm gonna use a switch statement. So I'm gonna look at the three check boxes, and there's gonna be a blue checkbox, and there's gonna be a red checkbox, and there's gonna be a yellow checkbox. And based on what the checkboxes are, I'm gonna add them together. If the blue checkbox is checked, I'm gonna add 1. If the yellow checkbox is checked, I'm gonna add 2, because 0, 1, 0 is 2. If the red checkbox is checked, I'm gonna add 4, because 1, 0, 0 is 4. And what that's gonna give me is one of the 7 one of these seven. It's if none of them are checked, it's going to give me zero because that would be white. If just blue is checked, it'll give me blue. If just yellow is checked, it'll give me yellow. If just red is checked, it's going to be give me red. If blue and red is checked, it's going to be 1 + 4 = 5. So it'll give me purple. You know, if blue and yellow is checked, it's going to be 1 + 2 = 3, which is green. If red and yellow are checked, it's going to be 4 + 2, which is 6. That's orange. And if they're all checked, it's going to be red plus blue plus red plus yellow, and it's going to be black. Okay, so let's try to make some code to do this. That over there, I'm going to pop my toolbox in, pin it, and I'm going to, this doesn't have to be that big at all. And I'm going to start by, I want you all to do this, okay? I want you to start getting acclimated to this way of this convention of naming these controls. And it's the prefix. What's nice about the prefix is that you take best advantage of IntelliSense, okay? It's not the convention that you use in the textbook. It's not the convention you use in the textbook. It's a different convention. It's the convention that we use in 148 and 228. And in fact, if I were to have chosen this textbook, this would have been a definite negative because the way that this textbook has you name these, the convention is like you can't use IntelliSense for anything, and you'll see what I mean by that as we go along. I'm not going to take off any points or anything, but I don't know, at the end I might start taking off points. So first of all, this is not that important for forms, but it will be important the last chapter of the textbook that we're going to cover, and where we do a multi-form application, where we have an application that's got a bunch of forms. You know, you start out with a main form and you click something and a new form pops up to do some stuff, and you close it and go back to the main form and so on, where you have a bunch of forms. And so if we name the form, I like to say FRM main, let's say, or something. That's the main form. And for the text up here, I want to put something there. So let's find the text field. Right now it says form one. Oh, here it is. I'm going to say Rich's color mixer or some crazy thing like that. So that's what's up here. And I'm going to put a label up here, and I'm going to say, I'm going to make it, the text is going to say select colors, and I'm going to make it bigger, so I'm going to click on the font, and I'm going to change 8.25 to 12. I think I'm going to make it bold also. Bold, true, it's true, I want it bold. And then I'm going to put a couple of checkboxes here. One checkbox here. I'm going to copy paste twice. Copy, paste, paste. And I'll put a second checkbox here. I should have done my formatting first. For this checkbox, it's going to say blue. I'll make it blue. And I'm going to make it 12 point, and I think I'll make it bold. And that's blue, and I'm going to make the, and I'm going to name this checkbox, the blue text box, blue one, I'm going to name it, instead of checkbox one, I'm going to name it CHK blue. And I'm going to name this one CHK yellow. Make that my second one. And I'm going to make it say yellow. And I'm going to, should have done this before, but I'm going to make it 12 point. And I'm going to make it bold. And this third one, I'm going to make it 12 point bold. The text is going to say red. And the name is going to be CHK red. Okay, so I've got a blue one, which is called CHK blue. And I got a yellow one, which is called CHK yellow. And I got a red one, which is called CHK red. And, you know, I'm not going to bother with, I'm going to put a reset. I'm going to put a reset and an exit. But I'm going to make it so when you click on the checkbox, it actually makes the colors. And I'm only going to have one set of checkboxes because you can click more than one at a time. And so I'm going to make it when there's nothing checked, it's going to be white. If there's just the colors, it's going to be the colors. If you start doing combinations, you'll start to get this inside of this Venn diagram here. But I still want to have a reset. I'll put it over here. This will be reset and I'm going to name it BTN reset. And I think I will make it 12 point bold. So that's reset button. Why does it say button? I thought I made it say reset. What did I make reset? BTN. Reset to make it back to the system color. And then I'm going to have another copy paste here. Copy paste. And this is going to be exit. Text is going to say exit. And the name is not going to be button one as we see up here. The name is going to be BTN exit. All right, so I got that all set up now. And so let's start making some code. I'm just gonna switch over to, let me double click on exit. I'm gonna make this work first. And here it is, I'm gonna say this close. And let me do reset also. Reset, and I'm gonna blank out all the checkboxes. So I'm gonna say CHK blue checked equals false, CHK yellow checked equals false, and CHK red checked equals false. And I gotta set the background again to this background color equals system colors. Control. I think it's control. Yeah. I think that's what it is. All right. So that's button reset. And now let me do my. So I'm going to create my own method. I'm going to create a separate method to take care of reading everything and setting the colors. Yeah, that's fine. I'll do it that way. We haven't learned methods yet, have we? Well, all right. Well, we actually have been making methods all along because this is a method and this is a method. And so is this, and this, and so let's just make another method here. Private void, and I'm going to name it mixed colors. And I don't need to have any parameters. I'm just going to do that, and I'm going to do it. And so now I'm going to type in a method here. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to declare a variable called an integer variable, and it's going to be final color, or no, display color. And I'm going to set it equal to 0, which, by the way, is white. Start out with white. And then I'm going to say, if CHK blue checked, if that's true, then I want to say display color, I'm going to add what's blue. 001, that's one. Add one to it. Okay, so we know about plus equals. We know about plus equals yet? That's just gonna add one to one to whatever. Yeah, okay, so we could do this. Display color equals display color. Plus one. Okay, so that's blue, and then if check yellow checked, that's true, then display color equals display color plus whatever yellow is, and yellow is 010, which is binary for 2. And then we got to check if red is checked. So if check red checked, that's true, then display color equals display color plus 100, which is 4. Okay, so now I have my display color, and I'm gonna do this one step at a time, and I'm just gonna put some extra stuff in here, and I'm gonna put a label here, and I'm gonna say, I can make this smaller, because this just helped me display. This is what display color is, and let me put another label here. And I'm going to name this label. I'm just going to put an asterisk there, and I'm going to name this label because I'm refer to it. LBL display color. Display color number, because I'm going to have another display color. So that's going to be display color number. I'm going to make this display color number, because I'm going to also have a display number. Display color. That's fine. Whatever. Display color number. You know, I'm going to be consistent, and I'm just going to call this display color number. Display color number. What happened? I hit the sign. All right, I'll give you a little time to catch up. So I've declared this variable called display color number, because I'm going to use display color to hold the actual color. I have display color number, I start out with equal to 0, and then if I check to see if the blue checkbox is checked, if it is, it's gonna add 1 to it. If the yellow checkbox is checked, I'm gonna add a 2 to it. if the red checkbox is checked, I'm going to add 4 to it. And then I'm going to display out display color LBL display color number equals display color number. So that'll just tell me what it is. Why does it look like that? Ooh, it's a text property. All right, I'm sharing, and I think I'm recording. Yes, I'm recording. That's what the red dot is. All right. ToString. Gotta change it into a string. All right. This is pretty good. I'm just gonna test it. I'm gonna click start. It's not going to do anything because I don't, I can click away, but it's not going to do anything because I haven't set up any events. This works though. So I got to set up some events. Here's how I do that. I'm going to go back to here. I'm going to double click on blue. And I'm going to say, so now it's the blue event handler. I'm going to say, mix colors like that. That's how I call this method. I just put it there. That's right. And so that's my blue checkbox. And it doesn't matter what it is here, it's going to look here and see what it is. So I don't have to test if it's checked or not checked down here, because it's just going to go right here and execute this whole thing. Yeah, it's going to execute the whole thing. That's what it's going to do. It's the same. I'm going to do the same thing for this one. Double click that. And I'm going to say mix colors. And the same thing for this one here, double click. And I'm gonna say mixed colors. All right, so now I should be able to try it. Start this thing up. And when I click blue, it says 1. When I click yellow, it says 3, because blue plus yellow is green 3. When I click red, it says 7. When I uncheck the yellow, it says 5 because it's blue and red. So we got blue is 1, red is 4, and it's 5. I can have that's going to be just 4. Red and yellow is 6. And when I uncheck them all, it's going to go back to 0. So I've got that part good. Let me exit. So now that I have all these things here, now I can put my switch statement, because what I want to do is I want to look at color display number, and if it's 0, I want to set the background to white. If it's 1, I want to set the background to blue. If it's 2, I want to set the background to yellow. If it's 3, I want to set the background to green, and so on. So now I can use my switch. So I'm going to do switch, parentheses, display number color, parentheses, this thing. And the first one is going to be case 0, colon. When it's case 0, I want to make the this dot back color equals colors, is that what it is? Color dot white. And then break. And then case one colon, this back color equals color, what's one, blue. Break. And I want to add some other stuff here first. I want to add, I want to put here what the actual color is, just like I did before. So let me put a, I don't know, what do I put there? I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to copy paste this. Copy paste. I'm just going to say display color. That's that. And this is going to say, this is going to be LBL display color. And I'll leave that as an asterisk for now. Do I got to put some kind of background here so I can read it? Back color. I'm going to make the back color be, I don't know, white. I'll make this back color be white also. Except for when it's white, I won't be able to see it. Okay, so let's go back to here. So I'm going to say LBL display color dot TEXT equals white. And here I'm going to say LBL display color dot TEXT equals blue. Now I'm going to do some heavy copy pasting here because I'm lazy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And when it's got 0 and 1, when it's 2, it's going to be yellow. So let's make this yellow. And let's make this yellow. And when it's 3, it's going to be black, green. So when it's 3, I'm going to make this green. And this is going to be green. And when it is 4... it is red, and this is red. And when it is 5, it is 101, which is purple. Purple, and the display color is purple. And when it is 6, it is 110, which is orange. And this here is going to be also orange. And when it's 7, it's going to be black. Black and black. Now, I want to be able to see the display color text when it's white. So I'm going to do something else here. I'm going to, this display color title label, I'm going to name it because I want to refer to it. I'm going to call it LBL display color title, just because I want to give it a name. So now it's got a name. And I'm going to, in here, right here, I'm going to say LBL display color title dot back color equals colors. There's no colors. I can't do color. Can I do color? black just because I want to be able to see it. And I also want to say LBL display color dot text. Wait, how do I do color? Let me take a peek over here. It's this thing. Four color. Of course. Four color equals color black. No, white. No. White. Now the trouble is, once I hit white, then I've changed the color of those things permanently. So I gotta change them back. I gotta set them back. And the way I'm gonna do that is I'm gonna take these two here. I'm gonna copy them, and I'm gonna initialize them. I'll initialize them right here. And I want to initialize the back color as white. And I want to initialize the four color as black. And you'll see that work. All right, let's see if this works. Calling me from Indianapolis. Sorry. All right, let's run this and see what it looks like. Okay, blue, funk. I can't see that very well, can you? Yellow. Oh, yellow and blue make green, all right. Blue, yellow, red make black. I guess it's black. Let me undo this. Purple, okay. Undo this. Oh, red, that's nice. Undo this. Oh, that didn't work. It didn't work out too well, did it? Let me reset. Okay, we're back to system color. I know what I did wrong. Let me exit this. I set these wrong. Okay, the color title back color has got to be black, and this has got to be LBL display color title dot for color has got to be equal to color white. And the LBL color is the same with this one. LBL display color dot back color. It's got to equal color black. Yeah. And that blue looks pretty bad, so I'm going to do the same thing for... Oh, wait a second. I didn't mean to do that. I meant to put this. This has got to go. Oh, shoot. I didn't mean to put it there. I meant to put it up here. All right. So it's okay. We're starting now. We want the display color title back color to be white, and the display color title for color to be black, and we want the display color back color to be white, and this display color for color to be black. Okay, that's how we want to initialize it. And, but when it's white, we want them made the opposite. And so, because we can't see it, well, I'm just, All right, that seems to work. Now the background color is white. Oh no, that's not what I want to see. What is back to white? There we go. That's what I want white to look like. What? I'm confused. What does it look like when it's black? What does it look like when it's blue? All right, I was confused, but this works. So let's just leave it like this. So I'm always making the background color of these two words be white. I'm always making the four color to be, why doing that? You know, it doesn't. Yeah, this I'm doing that. That's kind of silly, but sure, that looks okay. I don't really need to do that, this, I guess. I guess if I just make the background color white all the time, like I did in the other assignment, then it would work. So I can probably, let me reset it. Let's just make it that way all the time. And what happens if I don't? I'm gonna get rid of that. Let me see what this looks like. Blue, yellow, red, white. Yeah, okay. And this doesn't do anything. The four color is always black, so I don't even need these either. As long as I don't mess with them. So I don't need that, and I might as well do the other ones too. So I'm gonna say I'm gonna name it. Rename this one. This is named LBL display color title, and this is gonna be named LBL, this is going to be named LBL display color title, a number title. That's what that's going to be named. And this is just display color number. So let's make, let me get rid of these commented fields since I don't need them anymore. Thinking was wrong. See, that's what happens when you do these things on the fly. I'm going to change the background color of display color. Let's do this right. Number. Number. All right. So I've made my the text labels down at the bottom. I made the text labels down at the bottom so the background color is always white. And the text colors themselves will always be black because I'm not messing. So they should always be black. Now this should work. And we do blue, yellow, red. I'm sorry. So that's black. And we reset it. That's good. That's good. All right, so I didn't get into list boxes. I guess we'll cover, you know, this, but the list, I'll cover that next time. It just take 5 minutes. It's not very interesting right now because we aren't doing much with them. And you really have to understand collections before you can really do a lot of stuff with list boxes. So I'm gonna close it up now. It's late, it's 4:32. And are there any questions? Okay, so remember, you gotta tune in live or come to class next Thursday. You gotta tune in live or come to class next Thursday, and I'll send an email out for that. So if there's not any more questions, I'll put this video up soon. Thanks for watching.